You know, when I look around at all the entrepreneurs who are grinding it out, spending 70 to 80 hours per week growing their business, you have to ask yourself the question, at what cost? Hi, my name's Tim Uchuk, and in this podcast, we're going to be exploring the tools, tactics, and strategies for crushing it and scaling your business without making the ultimate sacrifice of your time and freedom. Hey, what's up, everyone? Tim Uchuk here, and we had a little bit of a crisis yesterday. For those of you that caught our last podcast, we were on our way for a vacation, but we had a torrential downpour yesterday, and long story short, we started to get some water leaking into our basement, so we had to stall and delay things, and we're basically at home today getting a roofer to stop by our house. And so it's given me a little bit of time to do a little bit of work, and I'm not quite in vacation mode yet. So I wanted to record another podcast with something that's top of mind, and I wanted to share something a little bit embarrassing with you. I made a big mistake a few weeks ago in my consulting business. So again, for those of you who don't know, I run and I own and operate a manufacturing business. We build truck bodies and a couple of distribution businesses. And when I'm not doing that, running those businesses remotely, I have a consulting business where I help out other business owners to essentially structure and systemize their businesses as well. So being the guy that's teaching all of this stuff, it was a little bit embarrassing, but I was doing this stuff on an empty stomach. I was messing with my ads, my campaigns and ads on Facebook, because I drive a lot of traffic from Facebook to get generate appointments and leads and sales. And with three young kids, I just simply don't have time to do outreach and cold calling. I did a lot of that in my 20s. I've made thousands of cold calls, and I just don't have time for that anymore. So I use, you know, modern marketing strategies to generate sales. And in my opinion, it's the only way to go if you value your time and your sanity. So getting back to my story, I was hangry. So I hadn't had lunch yet. I had my bulletproof coffee in the morning, hadn't had lunch. And I was whizzing through my Facebook ads. And again, that's what I use to generate leads and move them into my sales funnel and all that kind of stuff. And so I'm going through everything, taking a look, and I decide to delete one of my campaigns that is not, I basically have a campaign that's outperforming another. I checked the wrong one, so I checked the one that's actually working and working really well for me, and I accidentally deleted it. It was gone. And for those of you guys that know Facebook, that messed up my pixel, so it messed up the algorithm and everything. And that was a big oh shit moment for me. And here's the moral of my story, is that if you own a business, one of the most valuable things that you can have is the ability to fish, to catch your own fish. Now, this is an area where a lot of companies, and I think it's a mistake, in my opinion, they outsource this stuff. They outsource the marketing part of their business. They outsource the lead getting and the conversion part of their business to marketing and ad agencies. And when we had done this in my past life in our business and had gotten burnt from these people who maybe they took a course over a weekend and now they have our money, they're spending our money to generate sales. Well, it's really easy to spend other people's money. And I decided that this is something that I want to master so that I will never go hungry. You know, if you know how to fish, you'll never go hungry again. And so, you know, I've devoted the last 3-4 years to figuring out modern marketing strategies. And so I wanted to share that embarrassing story with you. But long story short, because I have learned how to fish, so I knew how to generate my audiences there in Facebook and rewrite the copy and run some quick tests. I know what my numbers need to be. And then I built the thing, built my trap line and everything. And it took, you know, 2 or 3 days, but everything got back and got handled. Now, if I didn't know how to fish and I did not And I was relying on an ad agency, which, by the way, we've been burnt in the past by an ad agency who they've spent tens of thousands of dollars, you know, in our business, my own brick and mortar business. And that's where I decided, you know what, enough is enough. Totally vulnerable. This is such an important part of your business that you should not be hands off with, in my opinion. I mean, yeah, you can be very vulnerable if you're and you can be taken advantage of if you don't know what you're doing and you don't know this part of inside of your business. So, long story short, moral of the story is, if you want more control, peace of mind in your business, number one, I think it's worth investing your time and energy in learning how to fish. And number two, if you're not using some of these modern strategies, you're going to have to adapt, because you simply cannot compete with people who have mastered setting up systems and automating their lead generation, their nurturing, their sales conversions, their reselling, you know, generating referrals, managing all this stuff and systemizing and using modern technologies and automations is the only way to go. And if you're delaying, if you're on the fence, if you're even stuck, you're just in a vulnerable position. And yeah, take it from me, I'm not a super techie guy. But again, 4 years ago, I said to myself, this is a capability I lack. It's not a good situation. A year from now, you know, 2 years from now, I'm going to develop that capability. And so it just took me grinding it out. It was hard to figure it out, but I did. And then once I got to the other side, I mean, hindsight's 20/20. For me now, it seems pretty darn easy. Now that I can see how everything kind of fits together, all the puzzle pieces. But if you're at a place right now where you are feeling vulnerable in your business and you don't even know where to start, this is one of the things that we've systemized and packaged within our Perfect Week program to take the guesswork out of setting this stuff up. But I think, you know, moral of the story again, if you do not want to be caught being vulnerable in terms of, you know, knowing where your next lead or your next sale is going to come from, and it feels just very random and manual in your business, I think the best time to start is today. Well, the best time to plant a tree is 20 years ago, but I would get moving today, because those of us who aren't adapting, it's going to be a slow death. Anyways, on that note, I hope that serves as inspiration for you to learn how to fish. I mean, that's just one of the greatest gifts that you can give yourself and your business. I know for my kids, I'm mindful of, you know, when they're going to be of age to go to university and stuff, I'm going to be really spending time and energy teaching them how to fish. So if they had nothing, absolutely nothing, to equip them with the skills and the knowledge to fish, which means to, you know, either start up a business and set up a marketing and sales machine so that they can actually earn money and put food on the table. I mean, what greater skill is there than that? Anyways, I'm out. I'm going to grab a bite to eat for lunch. We're going to get our roof patched, hopefully, today. And then, fingers crossed, we'll get to hit the road tomorrow. Hope that was useful, guys. And I will talk to you soon.
Hey, Tim Uchuk here, and real quick, if you enjoyed this podcast episode, if you could take a couple quick seconds to give it a rating, it would be very much appreciated. And secondly, if you're looking for more tools and strategies on how you can crush it in life and business, just head on over to bookwithtim.com, where I've put together a free case study which shows you how to unlock unprecedented freedom today by using the two power levers. Just head on over to bookwithtim.com. Until next time, wishing you success and freedom in your business. Cheers.